old vignettes. A little bit longer. We met halfway in Marianna, a 64.3-mile drive from me. I left my car in the car park of a Winn-Dixie. He drove in his warm van to Tallahassee and walked up steps painted gray-green to his apartment. He has a cat and it's cluttered but clean. We watched a film on Ginsberg and didn't glean that much from it but kissing boys and beat poetry, which was enough for me. He heated ribs the old ladies made for him, too fatty but fine. We kissed and went to bed and it was like a movie scene. At 6:30 or 7 a.m., I heard television screams of televangelists from the lady underneath and couldn't help but feel so pleasantly unclean. His cat really likes me, or at least likes that I'm here to see her, and the sun is soft, and I feel as though I'm in a dream. We threw off routine and slept the day away, warm and hazy and almost obscenely languid, till the evening for dinner, a show, and drinking. We sat cheek to cheek on Jill's porch, drinking amaretto and tea on rocks or in coffee, and at chats I liked on and off about poetry. We slept at Jill's despite my cough and the pots of caffeine we drank, and in the dark I felt 14 again with touch and follow because I couldn't see. Sunday leaves and we're back at Jill's again, exchanging vulnerabilities, admissions with which we could destroy each other so easily, but I stroke his hair instead and hope he likes me. Against our better judgment, we sleep at Jill's again, with early mornings looming in the dark, his heat and beauty, we kiss, ignoring cat yells in the hall in between. Morning happens quickly.